So you had to talk to the president. Have you talked to the president since then?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, he was very gracious after the election. He invited me to the White House for lunch, and we ate in a little room off the Oval Office. And I'm not going to tell you what he said, but I took the occasion to say, look, I want you to succeed, Mr. President. You're the president of the greatest nation on earth. And I hope you think about what makes America a unique nation, what led us to be the greatest nation in the history of the earth, and you try and encourage more of those things to happen in this country, keep those principles, so that America can continue to defend freedom around the world.
That's great. And how do you think he's doing?
That's
very nice. How do you think he's doing?
I've been disappointed, to be truthful.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the centerpiece of his first 4 years was Obamacare, and that has not gone off terribly well. And our reputation around the world hasn't been enhanced in the way I'd hope. But, you know, he's got a couple more years to go, and hopefully he'll be able to lead the country. I mean, after all, he is the president of the country we all live in and love dearly, and I want him to succeed in keeping America strong.
What happened with the Obamacare thing? Because the idea behind it is good, but was it the rollout that just...
Well, I think there are two problems.
I shouldn't have worked on the website. That was a mistake. They shouldn't have hired me. I shouldn't have done that. Yeah. I don't know anything
probably,
about websites.
Probably right. Yeah. Probably right.
I was called GoDaddy.
Well,
you know, I don't know. They'll do it. I don't know. They could figure it out.
You know, one challenge, of course, was just the website, the implementation of the technology, and that's still kind of a mess. And it's hard to understand how something that was so important to the president would not have received enough attention to be done properly. But that'll ultimately be solved. And a lot of people will be upset and hurt during the process. But longer term, the problem is people are going to lose insurance they wanted. Doctors that people expected to be able to keep, they're not going to be able to keep. Premiums will go up. It's not going to be real popular for a lot of folks.
You got a lot of attention and a lot of kudos for running the 2002 Salt Lake?
Yeah.
Salt Lake City Olympics, Winter Olympics. Now it's in Sochi, in Russia. I don't even know. I never heard of the word Sochi in my life until this year. I was like, I don't know. But now that's where the Olympics are. And it's scaring me because I'm just hearing a lot of stuff about it's not safe. And what's your thoughts on that? Anything?
Well, you know, with our games, they occurred just a few months after September 11th. And so we were very, very concerned that we might also be a target. And as a result, our government and our organization put together an extraordinary plan to provide security for the games. But the heart of security is not just the fences and the magnetometers and the guys that are checking folks as they go into the venues. It's really the intelligence work that goes on to find out who are the potential threats. And I know the Russians have done a very effective job in trying to organize that kind of effort. My guess is what they've done is unprecedented in terms of the resources they've applied for security. I would feel safe going to Sochi.
You would?
Yeah, I would. That doesn't mean that anything is 100% guaranteed in the world of terror.
Yeah.
But I believe the hard venues, for instance, the sporting events and the like will be safe.
Well, let's hope for that. I want to show everyone a clip of this documentary. You're going to love this. Here's a peek at the Romney family on election night in the new documentary Mitt on Netflix. Take a look.
I feel like I just need to lay down on the ground and throw up.
How's
everyone so calm?
I'm not.
Oh my gosh. I'm just
like
dying.
It's
finally hitting me.
Get the panic out.
Panicsville.
Get the panic out.
I really want to go slap him in the face right now. Slap me as hard as you can. Go for it.
Ready?
Go for it.
I need one on the other side. Match it up. Match it up.
Oh, this is good.
That was
funny.
Right now, CNN has you're up by 500 votes.
Where?
That's not good.
Florida.
That's not good.
It's unbelievable. Mitt Romney right there. Please come back whenever you want.
Thank you
so much for being
the best.
Mitt streaming on Netflix right now. Jay-